Many people experience Herman Miller but don't know that they're experiencing Herman Miller. They only know that they're comfortable. Herman Miller's history has evolved from being a residential furniture company. And in the late 20s, early 30s, we started to shift from being a copier of dominant designs in Europe and elsewhere in the world to really establishing an ethos of design, which is contemporary American modern furniture. Many products in Herman Miller's history have risen to a level of iconography, like the Aeron chair. The design philosophy of Herman Miller is fundamentally premised on human-centered problem solving. It's really digging deep into a problem that we think exists in the world, yet to be satisfied. Herman Miller's design process is pretty unique. We don't have an internal studio. What we want to do is bring the voice of the world. And so we've chosen to use an entirely external network of designers from around the world and then map them to the problems that we're facing as a business. I think one of the keys to Herman Miller's success is the deep trust that the designers have in us and we have in them. The founder of our company would have called that having a deferential spirit to design provocation. And what that means is, if we can put the designer in a position to speak the truth from their perspective, they will bring Herman Miller to a place it can't get to on its own. Miller is always confronted with balancing form and function. The form is what you experience with your eyes, what you might feel with your hand. The function is your body's interaction or the movement of your body or the actual tool that you're using. Ultimately, all the decisions we make, from the materials that are chosen, from how we shape those molecules into structures and to beautiful artifacts, ultimately, the true purpose of any design is to serve a human experience in some way. I often tease people with the thought that this building is like a failure factory. We're going to produce those failures, both physically and intellectually, here, and tease out all of the failure, so that by the time you're experiencing a design from Herman Miller, you're really experiencing something that is durable, is unified, and has a sense of integrity and inevitability. So when we think about the way we live our lives and the things that we often, unfortunately, don't realize the perfection. We only realize the imperfections. And so for me, and for the designers we work with, I think what we're really trying to do is not be making statements. We're just trying to serve. And if you do the work of serving well, people will have great experiences and come to love the brand. The brand of Herman Miller is ultimately served by the quality of the human experience created. The brand and our profitability as a company will take care of itself if we're doing great work. Serve humanity first, the business will follow.